Welcome back, class 8, to the online bio class. Today we are going to complete the answers of chapter 3, that is ecosystem. Now, starting with the question which is there on your page number 62 in text question, we are starting with that one only because page number 56 already we have done, I think. All non-living things present on page number 56. Okay, starts with page 56. Number 1, name the following it is. First question is, all non-living things present in an ecosystem, they are called abiotic component of the ecosystem. Abiotic component of the ecosystem. Number 2, the question is, organisms that cannot produce their own food, they are called heterotrophs. So answer is heterotrophs. H-E-T-E-R-O, heterotrophs, T-R-O-P-H-S. Then third question is, category of consumers to which lions and tiger belong, they are secondary consumers. Lion and tigers are not primary consumers because primary consumers are the one who depend on plants for their food. They are herbivores. For secondary consumers, they are the carnivores. Then number 4 is animals which feed on both plants and animals, they are called omnivores. And the 5th and the last question is, organisms that feed on dead and decaying organic matter, they are called decomposers. Don't confuse with the detritivores, because they are also the one which feed on dead and decaying organic matter. Then we have page number 62, the next page. In text, self-check questions are there, one word. Number 1 on page 62. One more question is there on page 58, that correct the false statements by changing the underlying words. Number 1, decomposition can break down dead and living organic matter. So I write it there, that also page number is 58. Okay. So question number 1 it is living, dead and living is there underlined, so you should write dead and decaying. Instead of living, the word will be decaying organic matter. Number 2, the wave-like pattern of feeding relationship is called food chain. The word chain is underlined, you have to replace it by food wave, W-E-B, wave. Third one is heterotrophs that depend on producers directly or indirectly for food are the decomposers. Heterotrophs that they are not decomposers, they are known as consumers. Underlined word is decomposers, and you have to change it with consumers. The correct answer should be consumers. Then fourth one is, in a symbiotic relationship, three organisms live together for a mutual benefit. The word three is underlined, you have to replace it by two organisms live together for mutual benefit. And number 5, an example of predation is the relationship between a tiger and a lion. So both are, lion is underlined, it should be, instead of lion, it should be a goat or a deer. Okay? So change that word lion into a deer. Now next page, already I said page number 62. Let's go to page 62. The question is, name the following. Okay? Number 1, an abiotic component of ecosystem which helps the seeds to disperse. Number 1 is air or wind, also you can write. Air or wind, both are correct. It is abiotic component. Number 2, the summer sleep or state of inactivity and long summer sleep in some animals, it is called estivation. Okay, the word is estivation. Then third one is, the top layers of trees in a forest ecosystem where tallest trees can reach, it is called emergent layer. E-M-E-R-G-E-N-T. Emergent layer. Then the fourth question is, all animals life found in a particular area is called fauna. F-A-U-N-A. This is not T, it is F. F-A-U-N-A. Fauna. Okay. And the last word, number 5, one I am writing it here, place is not there, is the layer in forest ecosystem devoid of sunlight, it is called forest floor. involved in text questions are completed. Now we'll move on to the exercises. Okay. Okay, let's start the next one, that is section 1, exercises of your textbook. Question number 1, that is question number A, first one, number 1 is the living components of an ecosystem. The living components are called biotic components. Biotic components. Okay, number 2, the question is, organisms that depend directly on plants to get their food and energy, it is called herbivores. Okay, number 2 answer is herbivores. Then third one, the third question is, animals which feed on both plants and animals, just now we are done, it is called omnivores. Such animals which feed on both plants as well as animals. Number 4, relationship between two organisms that one organism benefits at the expense of other, it is called parasitism. P-A-R-A-S-I-T-I-S-M. Not parasite, parasitism is the name of the relationship. Okay. Number 5 is forests that are found along the equator between the Tropic of Cancer and Capricorn. It is called tropical rainforest. It is called tropical rainforest. This one is complete. Now question number B is fill in the blanks. Okay, first question is, and dash is a self-sustaining unit, an ecosystem is a self-sustaining unit. Then number 2, dash forms the base of food pyramid. Answer is producers. They are always at the base. Third one is, multiple food chains connected naturally form food wave. When food chains are connected, they form a food wave, that is interconnected network of food chain. Number 4 is, animals feeding on dead or decomposing matter are called, answer is decomposers. And the fifth and the last question of this group, fill in the blanks, dash refers to the plants found in an area. They are called fauna, flora, F-L-O-R-A. Flora is the name of the plants. If animals, we say it as fauna. So F-L-O-R-A, flora you can write, okay? Now next question we have, number C. That is, match the following. No, choose the correct answer, it is, okay? C, number 1. An example of biotic component of ecosystem is, number 1, B. Number 2 is, heterotroph organisms are, correct answer is D, that is herbivores and carnivores both. Then third one is, tertiary consumers are, the correct answer is C, that is animals that feed on other carnivores. And the fourth one is, which of the following is an example of symbiotic relationship? So BP plant and rhizobium, that answer is correct. And number 5, which layer is inhabited by herbs and shrubs found in a forest ecosystem? The correct answer is understory layer, that is number D. Okay, so this one is also complete. Now question number D, which is right, true or false. Number 1, decomposers are biotic components of an ecosystem. It is true. Number 2, omnivores are organisms that break down the dead and decaying organic matter. So it is false. We have to cut the first word because it's written condition. You have to change the first or the last word. So omnivores you can write, cut it, and instead of omnivores, you can write as decomposers. Decomposers. Okay, then the third question is number 3, consumers help keep the environment clean and bring about recycling of nutrients. So third one is again false. What you have to do is, you have to change the consumers, and instead of consumers you must write detrivores. Then the fourth question is, which of the following is an example of symbiotic relationship? The energy flow along a food chain and the number of individuals at each level gradually decreases as we go higher up. It is correct, so we'll write true. And the fifth question of the last one, rhizobium is a parasite, it is a false. You can change the word rhizobium and instead of that you can write tapeworm is a parasite. So from that rhizobium, the first word of that sentence, instead of that write tapeworm, which is correct answer, it is a parasite. Okay, so now next we have to do is question number E, which is choose the correct options to fill in the blanks. Okay, now the next question we have to do is number E, that is choose the correct answer. Okay, first one is plants absorb solar energy. So first you will write solar. And the second blank in the same sentence, convert it into chemical energy. So after comma, I am writing chemical. This is for the second blank. For the first blank, solar, second blank, chemical. Second question is, primary or secondary consumers consists of animals that feed on plants. So it should be primary consumers. Then number three, or the third question is, tapeworm or rhizobium lives in the gut and derives nutrition from man. So answer is tapeworm. And the fourth one is, camels or seals live in the desert. So first blank you write camels. And the second blank you write seals. And the last fill in the blanks, number five, temperate or deciduous. Temperate, deciduous or evergreen forest. So answer should be deciduous forest. Deciduous. You have to select the deciduous one. Okay. Now choose the odd one. After that, match the following question number F. First one is bacteria. And why? The reason is because rest are abiotic components of an ecosystem. Rest are abiotic components of an ecosystem. Okay, then number two, the second question is, odd one is temperature. And the reason you need to write, rest are categories of biotic component. Rest are categories of biotic component. Then third one is water is the odd one. Rest are biotic components of an ecosystem. Same like this. Same like you have written here. Rest are biotic components of an ecosystem. And the fourth and the last question of this group is mahogany, the odd one. Mahogany. And the reason is rest are coniferous trees. Rest are coniferous trees. Okay, now we have match the following, that is question number G. I'll try to finish it here only. Question number G. Number one, that is plant, matches with C. Number two, that is bacteria, matches with A, that is decomposer. Number three, that is cow, matches with E, which is primary consumer. Number four, that is tiger, matches with F, that is a carnivore. And number five, which is human, matches with B, which is omnivore. So in this way we have completed section one of the question answers. Now we have to move on to the next section, that is section 2. Okay, now next we have to do is section number 2, question number A. It is section 2, okay. Question number A, give reasons for the following. Decomposers help keep the environment clean. So number 1 answer is decomposers help keep the environment clean. Decomposers help keep the environment clean by breaking down the dead and decaying organic matter. Okay. Next, number 2, or the second question is, the energy flow along the chain of a food chain, the number of individuals at each level gradually decreases as we go higher up. I will directly write the answer. To create a pyramid shaped structure. You write from the question only. To create a pyramid shaped structure. Then number 3, or the third question is, Siberian cranes migrate long distances. Siberian, yeah, spelling correct. Siberian spelling. Siberian. Siberian cranes migrate long distances. In order to avoid harsh winter. Then the fourth question is, forests found along the equator are called rainforest because, don't start your answer from because, you start from the question only. Forest found along the rain equator are called rainforest. After that, this one, because of the abundance of rainfall received by these regions throughout the year. Okay. Then question number B, you have to define or explain the following terms. So B1 we can write here at least. Is producers are organisms. Producers are organisms that produce their own food. Own food. Also called autotrophs. Example, all green plants. Are autotrophs or producers. Now next we have to do number 2. that is scavengers. What is scavengers? Scavengers are carnivorous animals. That feed on remains of dead animals . Example you can write is vultures. Okay, number 3 we have parasitism. Is a relationship between two organisms. Parasitism is a relationship between two organisms. Okay. Such that one organism benefits at the expense of other. At the expense of other. Example, tapeworm. The number 4 is pyramid of number. Is a representation of the number of producers and consumers in a food chain. And the last one, number 5, abiotic components. All the non-living physical components of the ecosystem are called abiotic components. Okay, example, air, water, soil, you can write, etc. Alright, then the next question we have to do is number C, D, E and F. That I will show you in the papers only, and after watching the video you can write your name, or in the comment section you can write a sentence how you like it. Okay, and you can also like. Thank you. Next question that we have to do is question number C. Differentiate between the following based on what is given in the brackets. First question is producers and consumers. Only example. So examples you can write anyone, like producers, grass, trees, algae, and consumers, dog, cat, and lion. Second question is scavengers and decomposers, mode of action. So answer is scavengers feed on remains of dead animals, example vulture and hyenas, whereas decomposers break down dead and decaying matter, example bacteria and fungi. Okay, then third question is differentiate between parasitism and cytism and symbiosis, the organism benefited. In parasitism, parasite is benefited, whereas in symbiosis, both organisms are mutually benefited. Okay, then next question number 4, tropical rainforest and boreal forest location. Tropical rainforest is found along the equatorial or equator between the Tropic of Cancer and Capricorn, whereas boreal forest is found towards the north of temperate forest around Canada, Siberia, Mongolia and Russia. Then last question number 5 is flora and fauna. Definition you have tried. Flora refers to the plants that are found in an area, and fauna refers to the animals that are found in an area. Next question we have to do is define number A, food chain. Okay, the answer of food chain on page number, it is 56. A paragraph is there. You can start from here. The feeding relationship between different organisms through which energy is transferred step by step from the producers to the consumers is called the food chain. Okay, so start from here up to food chain. Okay, next one. Next question is, you can see number B, scavengers. Okay, scavengers. Okay, come to page number 55 for that answer. Scavengers, you can see on the second paragraph. Scavengers are carnivorous animals that feed on remains of dead animals. Vultures and hyenas are examples of scavengers. Okay, this much you can write. Next. Next question, you can see number C is detritus. Define number C, detritus. Okay, so detritus, you will get it on page number 60. Yeah, here detritus you will get on page number 57. Wait. Detritus. Yeah, you will get it on page number 55. Okay, decomposers and detritivores. The word detritus is written here, you can see. So what is detritus? Detritus are, you have to make it in writing. Detritus are small fragments of decomposing or dead materials. So you can write like this, small fragments of decomposing or dead materials are called detritus. Only R you have to add and start from this one, small fragments. Okay, got it? Okay, next question is, you can see after detritus, number D is predators. P-R-E-D-A-T-O-R-S, predators. Okay. It is on page number 59, predators. Predation is there, predator is here. The hunter is called predator. So what is predation? Predation, the definition which is asked in your book is that of predators. So you can make it in right. Predators are those animals that hunt other animals for their food. Once again, I am repeating, predators are those animals that hunt other animals for their food. Example is, you can say tiger is a predator which kills or hunts the deer for food. The tiger hunts and kills deer for food. So tiger is a predator and the deer is the prey, P-R-E-Y. So you don't have to write prey, only predator definition you write. Okay, next. The next one you can see is symbiosis, symbiosis. Question number E, define the last one, symbiosis. Okay, so what is symbiosis? You can see on page number 58. Page number 58 I have marked here. Symbiosis definition is given there. Symbiosis is a relationship between two organisms such that both organisms mutually benefit from the relationship. Example, if you need to write, you can write the root nodules of rhizobium bacteria. You can write rhizobium in the root nodules of leguminous plants. Okay. Now, next question, we have to do short questions. Okay, short questions, you can see. Number E, what is an ecosystem? Okay, come to the first page, page 53 of the chapter 3. An ecosystem is a self-sustaining unit that consists of living organisms in a particular area interacting with one another and with their non-living natural environment, up to environment. Example, ponds, forest, grassland, you can write, okay? Example also you should write, okay? Now, next question we have to do. That is number two. Yeah, number two is name the different abiotic components. Name the different abiotic components of an ecosystem. Only name is required, so no need to explain it, okay? Okay, you can see there, a paragraph, same page, 53, abiotic components are there, only name is required. So, you should write from there, air, water, rocks and soil, as well as sunlight, humidity, temperature, are called abiotic components. So, only names you should write, okay? Now, the next question is, what is predator? Just now you have done, remember, question number 3, what is predation? And here you have done predators. So from the same page, same paragraph, you will get this answer, what is a predator, okay? Yeah, come to page number 59 once again, first paragraph. Predation is a relationship between two organisms such that one organism hunts down the other for food, okay? In this case, the hunter is called predator, while the hunted animal is called a prey. Up to prey, you can write P-R-E-Y, this much only, okay? Now, the next question, number 4, name any two plants and animals found in boreal forest. Two plants and two animals in boreal forest. Answer is, on page number 61, flora means plants. So, two plants name you have tried, that is on next page. Okay, the next page you can see, pine, fir and spruce. So, any two names you can write, pine and fir you can write. And fauna means animals. The animals which are found here, you can write is foxes, and you can write wolves, W-O-L-V-E-S, wolves and foxes. These two names you can write, okay? Next question you can see, number 5. What is the role of plants in a food chain? Okay, what is the role of plants in a food chain? From yourself you can make that the plants or the producers, pyramid of number from this paragraph, first line, the producers or green plants, because green plants are the producers, provide food to all other organisms on the earth in a food chain. Like this you make and write. Got it? So the producers or plants, you can write here add, or plants, provide food to all other organisms on the earth in the food chain. Got it? Now, the next question that we have to do is, what is pyramid of numbers? Just now we have done question number 6, what is pyramid of numbers? The same page, that is page 57, pyramid of numbers, the definition is given here. Pyramid of numbers is a representation of the number of producers and consumers in a food chain, up to food chain you will write. Got it? So, in this way we have finished the short answer questions. Now, come to the long answer questions. Number 1, give an account of the different categories of consumer based on feeding habits. Okay, different categories of consumers. Okay, come to page number 54 and you will write your answer from, the different categories of consumers are based on their feeding habits. Consumers from this line, based on, in consumers paragraph, based on their feeding habits, consumers can be of the three types. Primary consumers, they depend directly on plants for their food and energy. They are herbivorous, means animals that eat plants. And then example, you can write cow, goat, deer. The next you write secondary consumers. These organisms depend indirectly on plants for their food and energy. They are carnivores, that is animals that eat flesh of herbivores. An example, you can write lion, tiger. Then tertiary consumers, you write, these organisms depend directly indirectly on plants for their food and energy. They are the animals that feed on the flesh of other carnivores. Up to carnivores you'll write. And then example you'll write, a hawk is a tertiary consumer. So hawk you can write. Got it? So first question is complete. Now the second question is, number two, explain the food chain and the food web. Food chain and food web. Okay, come to page number 56. Food chain and food web. So first you write the definition of food chain, from the feeding relationship up to food chain, and then you write about the food web. Food web is also given there. Okay, so what is food web? You write from here that in nature, the same plants and animals can be eaten by more than one organism. This network of food chain is called a food web. Here the definition is given there. In the next page, a complex, don't write this creates, you write from there, a complex web-like pattern of multiple food chains connected naturally is known as a food web. If you want, you can write one example of both. Okay, like one example of food chain, you can write carrots or the grass eaten by grasshopper, grasshopper eaten by frog, frog eaten by python, python eaten by eagle. And food web example, you can write the grass is eaten by insect, grass is eaten by rat, grass is eaten by butterfly, like this. And the butterfly eaten by give arrow and write. Got it? Now, okay, next question number three. How does air, water and soil impact on the living components of an ecosystem? Air, water and soil. Okay, answer is on page 59. Physical components. Air means here oxygen will be there. So you can write oxygen is required by plants and animals for respiration, while carbon dioxide is important to carry out photosynthesis in plants. Then you can write this point also. Water, one point you write. Water is important because plants need water to make food during photosynthesis. Water is necessary for seed germination. 2 points here. Then here also you write 2 points. Moving air called wind helps in dispersal of pollen grains and seed plants. So two points from each. So air, water and third one was temperature, not the soil. I hope it is not soil. Yeah, you can check the question once again. How does air, water and soil? Okay, so soil is the next paragraph. 2 points from soil you can write, like soil is the dwelling place, means home, to a large number of animals like rats, moles, earthworms. Soil provides water and nutrients needed for the growth and development of plants. So third point and first point you can write. Okay, finished this question also. Now the next question number four. Give a comparative account of flora and fauna in tropical rainforest and temperate forest. So what you'll do is you'll make a table like in which you write first the tropical rainforest, and then you write like this, draw a line, temperate forest, and then here in the left side you'll write first one is flora and then fauna. Okay, so first one is we have to do is tropical rainforest. Okay, tropical rainforest, you can see what are the flora and fauna, like these two headings are given. So like this only you will give two headings, then in the middle you will draw a line. This is for tropical rainforest, the other one is for temperate rainforest. Temperate forest it is asked, I think. Yeah, temperate forest. Yeah, you can see temperate forest. So first you write flora, which plants are found in this place. So you can write sequoia, rubber, ebony, mahogany. Okay, mosses and ferns. Then in case of temperate forest, the flora which is found, they consist of trees like maple, birch, elm. They also consist of trees like fig, oak, laurel. So all these names of the trees you can write by making two headings. Then under tropical rainforest, in the animal section or fauna, you write which animals found, like monkeys, bats, gorillas, snakes, lizards, jaguars, sloth bear, tree frogs, then hornbills, macaws, these birds like this one also found, butterflies. And in case of temperate forest, you write the animals which are present here is mountain lion, koala bear, squirrels, black bear, birds like bald eagle, bird owl, and pileated woodpeckers. So birds also you can write, animals also you can write. Only animals write, birds you leave it, because birds is not asked. Okay, so first you write about the plants which are found in both.
Then about animals you write, which is found in both. Okay, like a table form, that will be nice, easy to learn. Now the next question which you have to do is number 5. How does energy flow in a food chain? Explain. Flow of energy in a food chain, you have to explain it. So answer is on page number, you can see the page number is 57, paragraph is energy flow in ecosystem. You have to explain from this paragraph. You start from there. Food energy is transferred from producers to herbivores and then to carnivores. Solar energy enters the food chain by photosynthesis into plants and get converted into chemical energy in food. Out of 100% solar energy, 90% is used up and only 10% stored energy passes to herbivores. Like this you can write, okay? When a herbivore feeds on producer, this 10% stored energy is transferred to it. Then of the 10% energy the herbivore receives by feeding, it uses 90% and stores only the remaining 10%. Similarly, when a carnivore feeds on herbivore, it receives only stored 10% of the energy of herbivores. So up to herbivore you can write, okay? And the last question we have is draw a food web involving a network of food chain. A food web diagram you need to draw, which is given on page number 57. And this is the diagram you can see. You can pause the video for some time, those who don't have the book, and then they can draw it. Okay, so with this we have completed all the question answers. Now picture study there. This one you have to try it yourself. You try and do it. Question number 1, question number 2. Next page you can see question number 3 is also there. So you have to read the questions and try it yourself. Got it? So today this much only. Thank you.